Hello everybody, Zeff here with ZeffsTrading. Hope you guys are doing well today. April 22nd, 2024. We're going to be doing our daily chart review and then the 2000 tick chart. Pretty hard trading day, I'd say. Price action was, it was okay. A little hard to read though, especially these last few days. But, you know, that's just how it is. There's quite a few clear second entries and we'll go over those. But other than that, let's check out the daily chart. Broke finally a new high of the previous bar, so we broke above that 50-58 mark here. So maybe let's see if we get some upside potential finally back to the 21 EMA. We'll see. Or you know, if tomorrow we just break the low of 5006 below, and then probably you know turn back down. We did pause at the 5000 mark, that nice big round number, nice psychological number there. And so, yeah, we'll see what happens. Broke this trend. You know, had a pretty big correction. It was about 5 or 6%, I'm pretty sure, from the all-time highs. But nonetheless, we'll see how this thing does. Anyways, let's jump over to the 2000 tick chart. Okay, this is what it looks like for the 2000 tick chart. We had a nice trading range, but downward bias in the morning. Then about 11 o'clock, no news for today, but just starts to rally and rally, rally. Top out at 50, 76, 75, and you know, we correct here. And let's see if we got that 50% correction. And to the dot, that 50% correction. You'll see me use the Fibonacci's every now and then. The 50%, 78, 6, 618, you know, they definitely hit just depending on how you use them with context. And since a strong move like this, you can expect to move back down to at least 50%. And you just kind of use it as a pivot point. Nonetheless, let's jump into it. See what... Okay, here we go. Market opens at 9:30 our time, but what we had before pre-market was actually a couple of nice trades in here. And so about, you know, 4 o'clock, 7 starts. You know, if you are trading here, you have a nice move up. You get your break. You get a first entry, second entry short, outside bar closing on this low. Double top. It's a nice second entry right there. And you'll see the twos here, and just remember the previous bar, unless it's an outside bar, is going to be the signal bar. And I thought I'd just, you know, do this just so it's a little easier to see for the second entries and kind of where they should be being traded. So you'll see a lot of twos and not a lot of arrows, and that means it's completely out of context. Or bad signal bars, etc. So we get a nice move here, second entry short at 751, and then, you know, for the next hour before market opens, it kind of just sells off, goes down, chops sideways a little bit. You got a little bit of congestion across the board here, but you clearly see 1, 2, and 3 for this triple test. You know, I was thinking about marking this triple test here, but after a few bars, you realize it's complete congestion, so you should probably just, you know, get out for a couple ticks. But I could see how you'd want to take that triple test. Anyways, nonetheless, market opens here in a second at 9:30, and literally at market open you get a first entry, second entry short right at the 21 EMA, and technically by count you get a first entry, second entry long, third entry long. So it's tried 1, 2, 3 times to go higher, can't go higher, and I just realized this is all a big hoagie as well. Nice second entry short there, and it's by the count, new high, first entry, second entry long, it's a failure. So nice context there, and you're done before market opens, or as market is opening. This thing sells off here, probably get a decent runner if you trail this properly, but then just a few minutes later, you get a move up, first entry, pulls back, where? 21 EMA, looking for a break and new low, second entry short, beautiful move down to the new low. And then this is where the midline is for this trading range. And then we just chop sideways and we just get noisy here. So all these red boxes, remember, are going to be, if you're just new to watching, is congestion and overlapping bars. So you want to stay out of it unless you're specifically trading to buy low and sell high. Nonetheless, 9:43 comes. We find a bottom here, basically get a 1, 2, 3. So you get a nice little wedge and you get a move up, break, congestion. Break, couple legs to a new high. And then this one's tempting to take here. You get a move down, you get a first entry, pulls back, outside bar goes up, then down, second entry short, You'd have to do a limit order. Again, you're dropping it right into the 21 EMA. I've seen this pattern quite a few times now in the last few days. So make sure you drop a limit order. Make sure you have room to scalp out. But that's an aggressive trade there. And then we start the downtrend, and we get a first entry. We get a second entry long, and it fails. And sometimes with the indicator here, the count's a little different in how it registers highs and lows. So I'm always still manually looking at it. But I'm just nowhere to get in here, unfortunately. Find price gets stopped at, of course, the market open and pauses there for a second. As you can see, it comes down and trends up higher. You get a first entry, you get a second entry short, but it's too congested there. And you realize that, you see how strong that second entry short is by just waiting. Once you see it, you know, after three or four bars, just get out, just take the loss, take the small win, whatever it is, and just look for a new trade. Then you get a new low here by this outside bar, so the count's reset, and this is where the don't pay attention to the indicator. You get a first entry, pulls back, you get a second entry short, and a breakout of this congestion. So maybe you take that trade. It's aggressive. You have room to scalp back down to the EMA, and you know I saw that, so we'll put that as aggressive. Then the move continues down here after this break of this bigger channel, break, new low. And let's see if this is a measured move or not. And we get pretty darn close with a few ticks below. It's a nice measured move. We get a move down, break, and it just kind of goes to a very tight bear channel here, so you can't really get in. You know, depending on how you saw this, you know, I think this is a little congested here. But, you know, you're going with the trend, so, you know, when you get that first entry, second entry long, it's a failure. Then this double bottom here, you can clearly see first entry, second entry short. So maybe you take that trade, but I think it's too congested. And only if you know what you're really doing here. Nonetheless, we get a move down. And I saw this lower high here. Sorry, not a lower high. I saw this inside bar. Outside bar closes on its low, so you get a nice double bottom. Outside bar closing on its high, you get a first entry, no second entry short, and then this thing just continues right off here. So by the count, you get a move off the EMA. You start making higher lows, and then once you start seeing this really get away from the EMA, you kind of realize that, oh, okay, well, I think we might have changed something here. And with that measured move down, you can expect at least a slight correction to maybe back to the midline, which it does. And price just stays above EMA. And then this thing just starts trending. Again, no news. I'm not sure what caused this, but we don't need to know why. And unfortunately, there's just really nowhere to get in here. You know, you have double bottoms all across the board, but, you know, that's not part of our system. You just get a first entry, resets the count. You get a first entry. You get a second entry long. It's too far away from the EMA. It's an inside bar. Then you get this, and it moves up, and I think it breaks out of this channel here. And you get a 1, 2, 3. I basically just saw resistance across the board here, nice signal bar. New high a day, very bearish bar. You know, that's at least enough for a scalp. It's aggressive, for sure. You're going completely against the trend. You're trying to call a high. You know, you could argue kind of the same thing with this bar right here, and it works. But those, you know, those hammer bars work sometimes for a quick scalp. Just got to have great context. And with how much resistance across the board here, at least a test back down to the EMA seemed reasonable. But after that, you get moved down, you get a break, you get a first entry, second entry long, right at the key entry point. The only thing you got to be careful of with these is that there was overshoot with this upper channel. And so it sells off one more time. But then you get a 1, 2, 3. So you get a nice wedge pattern here. And then you get this higher low, and I mark this as aggressive. You know, I would like to see a first entry, second entry short, failure, higher low, but this is just a move up, sell off, and then, you know, you are looking for at least another measured move to the high here. And you do get a nice higher low here, good signal bar, and that's why it's marked aggressive. I think I needed more context for that one, but then it just trends up here, and you just unfortunately can't get anywhere in here. You get a first entry, second entry long, but you're going right into resistance after this double top. Again, then just takes off. goes higher, congestion, overlapping bars, outside bar closing on its low, sells off back to the EMA. Then you get a ICF first entry, second entry long, unfortunately bad signal bar, major congestion. But what you do see here is a first entry, second entry short, and it fails, and you get a double bottom. Again, aggressive trade, you're going right into resistance here and here. But maybe you take that trade if you really know what you're doing. This thing has been bullish the whole entire time up. It's above the EMA. And so context-wise, I think that's, you know, it's an aggressive trade, but I think the probability is at least 60%. Then we get a final move up here after we get a break of this channel. After we get a break of this channel right here and double bottoms, break new high. And there's really no reversal here that I saw, unfortunately, so could have been like this. It's just congestion across the board too, so it sells off here. Again, you just don't get really much to enter. It just sells off, and then you got to be really patient, and then you got to move, you know, down, and it's all these like very sloping moves. It's not very concurrent with the trend lines, so when you're trying to measure them or trying to draw them, they could be like this, and then it just starts sloping like this. And so you just have to watch it, look for the key entry points, and wait for something more stable. Then you get a move up, you get a break, and then you get a first entry, second entry short, lower high. And this lower high has plenty of room back down to the lows, so that's a nice first entry, second entry short, lower high. So you got two context trades there, and you're with the 1, 2, 3 on this trend line, plenty of room down to the midline or the bottom. And you get a first entry, you get a second entry long. By the count, if you visually see this, it's more of an advanced setup. But by the real count, I drew this little line so you can see a first entry pulls back, second entry short. And that's really the one you want to take right there if you're a little hesitant. That second entry short's picture perfect, basically. Except for this, I mean, it's a tick away, but you have a double top as well here. So yeah, first entry, second entry short right at the EMA, and now you realize you're in a downtrend, and this thing just sells off. So you get a really nice runner on that one. And then from the new low, you get a first entry, so you get your new low, you get your trend line, break, new low, and that's why I have this little line here so you can see it. Then you get a first entry, second entry short, and it fails, and then once that fails with that outside bar, that's a textbook failed second entry short, and you get a nice run up, at least back to the trend line there. Okay, and then after the trend line here, resets the count, so then you get a first entry, second entry short. You know, if you really know what you're doing and how to count this, then maybe you take that one right there. You can see how strong this trend line is. It's just not the best signal bar, but it is closing at least a little bearish. Then you get a lower high. It's too congested here. There's a 2 there, if you can see that. Gets a move down, break, new low, and then that kind of just leads into market close. And so little hard of a trading day to read the price action. The channels were hard to draw as well, so don't feel bad about that. I was having a hard time drawing them. Just draw them as best you can. Each data is a little different for everybody, so that's why. But yeah, there's a few second entry shorts here. And we'll just go over the best ones real quick. I think this one, definitely picture perfect. You know, very low risk, great second entry short with the trend. This second entry short here is definitely pretty good. You just have to be careful of the overshoot. But again, low risk trade. And then I think right here is probably the best second entry short you could have taken throughout the entire day. Clear, visual two-legged pullback, and by the count, first entry, second entry short, right rejection at the EMA with a good signal bar. This previous one's good too, but I think this is the trade of the day. Okay, hope you guys enjoyed this chart review. And let's see how tomorrow is.